we get started, I'd like to thank and recognize the appointed and elected officials that are here today. So if you would, please either stand or raise your hand if you're an appointed or elected official. Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the National Day of Racial Healing 2020 Proclamation Event. My name is Donald Wood, and I'm the Executive Director of Just Communities of Arkansas. When I was a little boy growing up in Arkansas, I was a sleepwalker. Many nights I would make my way through the hall, up and down the stairs, and always into other rooms of our home while in a deep state of slumber, all the while ignorant of the real world around me, yet aware enough to successfully navigate that world. And my family knew not to wake me while I'm on my zonked-out treks because of how confused and even angry I would become by the sudden jolt from an illusion that felt so certain and so comfortable to a reality that felt so disorienting and so painfully inconvenient. That's a common reaction for sleepwalkers, or really just about anyone invested in something that feels so real and then they see that it isn't. Whether rattled out of a sleepy fantasy or reckoning with the shocking history of our humanity, we too often respond unveiled naked truth with fear, disbelief, rage, sadness, guilt, and we try to defend our deceptive worldviews as real because those worlds are the ones we are educated in, the ones we work in, the ones we play in, the ones we worship in, the ones we raise our children in, and those worlds are just easier to live in for many of us, but not all of us. This needed reckoning with our shared history in Arkansas that unites us here today on the National Day of Racial Healing. Today, the Arkansas Peace and Justice Memorial Movement, or APJMM, begins our open and collective effort to facilitate the healing and transformation of our state's shared humanity, a humanity that realizes a dream where our children will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. To do that, APJMM's mission is twofold. First, to memorialize the victims of historical racialized violence in the state of Arkansas through public acknowledgement and commemoration. And second, to promote community-wide engagement in that process through events and dialogues that foster the restorative power of truth-telling, vulnerability, empathy, and hope. Focusing on having these honest conversations about our history, in formalizing spaces for memory, for reflection, for grieving, and for learning are critical to us co-creating the reality we want for ourselves and for our children. Suffering must be engaged, heard, recognized, and remembered before a society can recover from the atrocious history we share of slavery, mass violence, and systemic racism. Over the next 15 months, APJMM will be leading a countywide effort collaboration with the Equal Justice Initiative of Montgomery, Alabama, called the Pulaski County Community Remembrance Project. This is one of six community remembrance projects currently active or in development stages in Arkansas. To share more about the specific purpose and mission of these projects, I'd like to welcome to the podium Connor Johnson of the Garland County Community Remembrance Project, followed by Dr. Brian Mitchell, Assistant Professor of History at the University of Arkansas.
The NAACP has found a total of 4,743 lynchings in our country from 1882 to 1968. 79% of these took place in the South. So obviously, Arkansas faced social injustice. But how does this impact me? Mr. Queen wasn't just telling me about this project to share what he was involved in. He knew that I would fit perfectly with the group of students that were involved in this project. He noticed my compassion, my willingness to put others before myself, and my need to stand up for what I believe in that my family has instilled in me since I was young. But he could also see that I recognized my own privilege, my immunity to institutionalized racism, my bubble that allows people like me to ignore the inequity that surrounds all of our daily lives, my comfortable environment that allows people like me to walk blindly into the future, never noticing the scale is tilting in their favor. Anyone involved in this project that experiences privilege has to have something in them that makes them interested in this kind of work. Something that allows them to be sympathetic towards an experience that they've never experienced. Something that allows them to put themselves in someone else's shoes. This is empathy. Empathy is the ability to understand someone else's feelings. But the only way to understand someone else's feelings is by listening to what they've experienced. I don't face the atrocities others must face. But I'm horrified to be a part of a society that allows these atrocities to occur. Anthony Reagan, one of the innocent men Brian Stevenson fought to free from death row, says it best. You're either a part of the death squad or you're banging on the bars. The men on death row would make noise to make sure their fellow man would know that he wasn't alone. I don't want to be a part of the problem. I want to make noise. I want my fellow men to know that they're not alone. For too long, society has chosen to ignore the past in hopes that people would forget it. That only makes the wound fester. We must address the hard truth of the past in order to reconcile, to heal. The speeches you hear today may make you feel uncomfortable, but we should be uncomfortable and discontent with the state of the facts of our nation's hypocrisy. Accepting the reality of the evil that thrives in the world we live in isn't easy, but it's time to move past the facade. It's time to face the uncomfortable truth. It's time to seek truth. It's time for us. I was lucky in the sense that this project truly found me. It is an opportunity for which I couldn't be more grateful. A chance to play a small role in reconciling the people of our nation to come closer to the ideals we have claimed for so long. Thank you.
Students come to my class and they say, well, is there anything positive you can say about U.S. history? And I often tell them that there are plenty of things that are positive about U.S. history. We've come a long ways. We still have a long ways to go. But we can do that together. But that can only happen if we're willing to tell the truth about the past. Undo the lies that were taught generation after generation. Give names to the nameless people who occupy soils that are hallowed throughout our nation. Students often ask if I'm surprised when mass graves are found in Texas and when mass graves are found in Oklahoma. And I tell them that America's land is filled with the bodies of the unremembered. One of our responsibilities, and particularly my responsibility as a historian, is to try to bring closure to their bodies, to make sure that they're remembered, and make sure that that lesson of racialized violence, hate, and distrust is not passed on to another generation. So remember, it begins at home. It begins at work. It begins in every interaction that we have with one another. How do we build a broken nation? We build it one person at a time.
That were working towards racial equity. And as a result of that, that's how this day came into fruition. So 4 years ago, the W.K. Kellogg Foundation created the concept. Now today, there are, this day is observed in a total of 36 different states. But the state of Arkansas became number 36 this year, so let's give ourselves a January the 6th of this year, and we have some other proclamations that we're going to be talking about as well. So I wanted to say that there's also another governor, so there's actually two governors that have issued proclamations, Arkansas, and on Friday, the governor of Alabama actually had a press conference, a live press conference that they interrupted programming to issue a proclamation for the National Day of Racial Equity. Now, the National Day of Racial Equity, there are three principles that this day rests upon. One is truth, one is racial healing, and the other is transformation. Me being a wordsmith, I really like the etymology of words, so I looked up, what does the word truth mean? You know, a lot of people say this is true, that's true, but what does it really mean? And when I looked at the etymology of the word, I came to understand that the word truth means something that rests in consistency, something that rests in standards. So think about that. We have a day where we want to create an environment for ourselves and for our children that rests in consistency, that rests in standards. When we talk about racial healing, the word healing, I looked up the etymology of that word, and it means to make something whole again. So we want to rest in standards, we want to rest in consistency, we want to look to make our racial environment whole again. It's very divisive, it's very fractured. But when we look up transformation, the etymology of that word is to form or mold across the fact, so across trans. To form, to mold across the facts. So putting all that together, this day is, what we want to do is we want to begin today. Today is the first day of a 15-month process where we want to take the divisive nature of our racial relations here in the state of Arkansas, and we want to form and mold new relationships and new environments that are based on standards. That's what today is all about. David, Bill, if you guys can come up. Therese, if you can come up, please. One thing about racial healing is you cannot begin the practice of racial healing if you don't first sit down and start talking to each other. If you don't first sit down and have meaningful conversations with an S. You can't just have one conversation. You have to keep talking and keep talking and keep talking. We got an email back in November, right? We got an email back in November, Clarice and I, from Bill, who had visited EJI. And he came back and he said, I want to do something. And EJI said, well, you contact these people. See what you can do. So since then, us four, we've been having these conversations, and we get together on a regular basis, and we talk for about 90 minutes at a time. Sometimes it goes over. But that's what we're going to be doing over the next 15 months, if we're going to bring our communities together, and we're going to be all over Pulaski County having having these conversations. And so I just want you guys to join us. If you look in your program on the next page, it says Seeing Our History 2020. And we have a list of the conversations that we're going to be starting. And if you're really serious in being here, contact us. We have a phone number on there. You can send a text with your name and your email address so that we can keep you informed about everything that we're doing. Our website is on there. You can go to the website as well. So we just want to make sure that this is not an event. This is a process. So don't walk away from here thinking you've done something. I'm tired of this hashtag environment that we live in, where people do hashtags and they think they've done something. We have a lot of work that we need to do. So everyone needs to be able to roll up your sleeves and get to work. You guys understand? All right, with that, I want to, we have two friends, but we have many friends that have been working with us, but I received a call on Friday from Senator John Bozeman, apologizing because he had planned on being here today, but because of what's going on in D.C., he had to change his plans, but he sent me a letter that he asked me to read to you guys. All right. January 21st, 2020. Dear friends, it is my honor to help celebrate the first statewide observance of the National Day of Racial Healing. I am grateful to the Arkansas Peace and Justice Memorial Movement for leading this effort and bringing so many people together to make these events possible. In this week, when we also celebrate the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., I believe it important to reflect on his mission of pursuing justice and fairness for all people. His leadership in the civil rights movement was about spurring America to live up to the ideas of our founding, liberty and equality under the law for all. In their righteous pursuit of that goal, the leaders, activists, and participants championed this cause for African Americans, helped make the United States a more perfect union. The challenges we face in the 21st century require the best of all of us. It is critical that we come together to understand our history and embrace our shared humanity, values, and potential. By improving communications and appreciating the value of each and every one of us, we can build a brighter future together. I hope your events shine a new light on the cause of freedom and equality. I appreciate your efforts on behalf of Arkansas and our nation. Sincerely, John Bozeman, U.S. Senator. Now I want to bring up the Justice of the Peace, Barry Jefferson. He's here. The county judge, Barry Hyde, was supposed to be here, but he couldn't make it because he had a family emergency to attend to. But Justice of the Peace, Barry Jefferson, is here and wants to say a few words and then we'll do the proclamation.
I think it's very important that elected officials need to be a part of this. They
They need to stand up and speak up and speak out if something is wrong. They need to stand up and say when someone is being hurt, they need to be divorced. I'm glad to be divorced with District 10. I'm glad to be divorced with Pleasant County. I think that's very important. Sorry that Barry Hyde is not here today, but he asked me if I could come and do a confirmation for him that he would like to give. And another thing I need to apologize for, another reason, on my way up here running up because I was running late, I broke my glasses. So y'all all blurry after I took in. You don't see anyone out there. So I asked him if he could go ahead and do a confirmation for me. Please forgive me. Okay. Proclamation reads as such. Whereas we have been witness to the rise in racial divisiveness throughout our county, state, and country that threatens the very core of this great country's unified front. And whereas we understand and recognize that divisions along racial, ethnic, and religious lines are created and have created an increasingly polarized society need of healing, and whereas we must all work judiciously and earnestly to heal the wounds created by racial, ethnic, and religious bias, and to build an equitable and just society so that all men, women, and children can prosper. And whereas racial healing is a vital and crucial commitment to the education and social, mental, and overall well-being of all Pulaski County citizens, especially our county's children. And whereas all children have the right to learn, grow, and thrive in nourishing environments that avoid violating their rights to safety, dignity, and humanity, and it is our duty to protect these children and provide these supportive communities in which they may all be given the opportunity to succeed. And whereas we believe it is imperative to create open, supportive, and secure environments to serve as safe places for learning about, discussing, and acknowledging our traumatic past of racial and social injustices. And whereas if we all dedicate ourselves to the principles of truth, racial healing, and transformation, we can all bring about the necessary changes to thinking and behavior that will propel our county, our state, and our country forward as one unified force where racial, ethnic, and religious biases will become a thing of the past. And whereas we believe that a commitment to diversity, inclusion, and equity is essential to making this vision of racial healing a reality. And whereas the County of Pulaski, in conjunction with others throughout the state of Arkansas and the United States of America, acknowledges January 21st, 2020 as the National Day of Racial Healing and urges all citizens to promote racial healing and transformation in the ways that are best suited for them individually as a means to working together to ensure the best quality of life for every child. Now, therefore, pursuant to the motion of Pulaski County Judge Barry Hyde, the County of Pulaski officially recognizes January 21st, 2020 as the National Day of Racial Healing. Trenches and work towards a society that is more racially just. With that in mind, I would like to bring forward Tamika Edwards, George West, Deshaun Scarborough's representative, and a family member from the late state representative, John Walker Sr., because we have some citations and awards that we would like to issue. And Mr. Dwight Sutherland, the Chief of Staff of the Arkansas Secretary of State's office, will do those presentations.
It's my privilege to represent the Secretary, and knowing the Secretary as I do, I know that his heart is here with you all, his cause, his desire to give his heart to restore racial divisions, social divisions. Ms. Edwards is the Executive Director of the Social Justice Institute at Washington College. She has led the creation of a foundation that trains college students as advocates who are willing to challenge the lack of fair and just relations in our society, and to recognize the public policies that contribute to equity in this world. She also spearheaded the Race and Equality community discussion series, a series where Black and White citizens issues concerning race. The community thanks Ms. Edwards for her work and involvement in the fight for social justice issues. The second. Second commendation is Mr. George E. West. Mr. West was a renowned educator at the White Central High School. Okay. He was instrumental in developing alternative curriculum to encourage students to tell stories from their parents, grandparents, friends, and so on, Black or about their experience in the civil rights era. Their efforts led to a book on entitled Beyond After retiring, Mr. West continued to work with the students at Central High School, where he became involved in the LRCH Memory Project. The project involves an app and an audio walking tour called Words That Matter, Voices in Civil Rights, for the first day at Central High School. He also lends his expertise in education to the Clinton School of Learning by organizing a program that is used statewide by teachers to help develop their own community historian curriculum. The community is grateful for Mr. West's care and concern in educating our children through the civil rights history. Scarborough also crafted service announcements and initiatives that the new self-aid commission initiated to move forward towards community involvement, healing, and mutual understanding. The purpose of the announcements was to show that as a community, we must stand together with our law enforcement officials showing a positive interaction between them. The community is grateful for Mr. Scarborough's effort to promote the vision of healing, peace, social justice, and unity.
We have an event on Wednesday night, at the Cal's Ron Robinson Theater, starting at 6:30 p.m. The doors open at 5:30. We want all of you guys to come out and bring six friends, okay?
And if you notice, there are hashtag boards here that talks about for the National Day of Immigration Building, hashtag How We Heal.
University of Arkansas at Fayetteville just received the 10th one that opened